Yeah. We're ready to begin our worship. The same has applied the last several Sundays, applies this week as well. If we're in our seat, or we're standing or sitting, we're stationary, we don't have to wear a mask. If we tend to move around for any reason, we would have to wear a mask. We're not allowed to sing only the last hymn. And so we'll have a bit of music to fill in here and there and save your voice to the last hymn. And we'll begin there. And so we are ready to begin our worship. Good morning. Welcome in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to our time of worship. It's good to see a nice crowd here this morning. Certainly welcome people who are visiting with us and worshiping with us online. And people may worship with us this morning live as things happen. And I know many people watch our worship service later in the day and week. So good to have you here as well. A few quick announcements this morning. The Blessing Bag campaign has gone over extremely well. We've had many groups, organizations. We had a cub group show up here yesterday with almost a half a pickup load, seven little guys with parents and leaders, and many other groups as well. And so good. Technically, the deadline is today, but if you have had some goods that you would want to, some items to drop off, you can still do so, and we will accept them. We're just not advertising the campaign right now. But if you do have some things, we will still accept them. You may have already noticed in announcements, if you've been paying attention on Facebook and things like that, our concert, which was scheduled for a week or so away, has been canceled. Our vestry last Monday evening, through discussion, decided with the increasing cases and fear amongst people, it'd be a good idea to postpone our concert. Not so much for people who are coming in attendance. I think it's the same as this morning. People will be pretty safe. But we have cast and crew are moving around quite a bit. and so we are fearful of that. And to be cautious, we're going to postpone it. And who knows, in the spring, we may not need a good laugh after the winter, and so that would be a good thing. Just in case you're wondering, we have a large rolling machine and some crushed stone across in our parking lot there. We had Modern Paving dump a lot of stuff here during construction. And so the deal was is that when they finished up and took all their material away that they were taking out of the ditch, put it back in the ditch, that they would grade the land and roll in some grade A crushed stone. And so that's where that has come from. And now next Sunday to Sunday after, the fourth Sunday of Advent, there's two services, the Hanging in the Greens, which is in the morning, and Tracy will be phoning around looking for people and parts to help with the reading as well as the singing and things for that service. We're not allowed to have much congregational singing, but if individuals or a couple of people could come along in the same bubble and provide music in between, that would be great. 7 o'clock in the night on the 20th, we have the Tree of Memories. That service will be live on the internet, so if you hear, it's wonderful. If you'd like to participate but can't be here, we'll still use the internet as a part of that service. And lastly, Christmas Eve, which is coming very fast. I heard people this morning talking about the number of sleeps left. And so that's a way of doing it and counting it down, especially if we've got children. The 4:30 service is almost filled. And so you will need to register with Tracy. And the 7 o'clock is just starting to pick up some speed. So if you're hoping to come and join us live in person for Christmas Eve, please do so soon. This year we are not able to take more than the set amount. So depending on people register, we'll do the best we can with cheers. We can have a maximum of 100 and not one more. And so that will apply to both services. And so if you plan on attending Christmas Eve, best catch up to Tracy right now. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We continue now with the lighting of our Advent wreath, Advent 2.
Today is the second Sunday of Advent, the Sunday of peace.
Our peace is found in God and in his Son, Jesus Christ. John the Baptist and all the prophets remind us that to receive peace, we must be prepared for it.
We light this candle today to remind us that Christ is the Prince of Peace, the one promised from the beginning of the world. We thank God for the hope he gives us and for the peace he bestows. Let us pray.
O God of peace, Emmanuel, we pray you send your light into our hearts. Help us to be ready for the day and the hour of Christ's appearing. Work in our hearts at this time and help us prepare ourselves for the peace that he brings, the inner peace that tells us that we are united with you, and the utter peace which we come when he brings the return judge to world. Bless our worship, that it may be pleasing unto you, and bless us that we may prove to be your faithful servants. Amen. Please be seated for the proclamation of the word.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Comfort. O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, and she has received from the Lord's double hand for all of her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of the God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear, says to the cities of Judea. Here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lamb in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. The Lord of the Word, the Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will hear what God proclaims, Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. Near indeed in his salvation to those who fear him. Glory dwelling in our land.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
Kindness and truth shall meet. Justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield in its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps.
Lord, let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in the prophet Isaiah. See, I am sending my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. The voice of one crying out in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him. They were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locusts and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let me start today by asking you some questions to think about. Nobody needs to raise their hand or shout out, me. How many have your Christmas tree up? Me too. How many of you have your shopping started or even done? And if you do, I'm jealous. And how many of us have made close plans with family and friends for the holiday season, for Christmas dinner? Advent is all about preparation and planning, and we often hear it referred to as a time to get our hearts and our homes ready for the coming of Christ. It's a busy time, and it seems like there are a million things to do as we wait, especially if we're adults. Christmas trees, Christmas lights, shopping, baking, mailing the Christmas cards, Christmas concerts, gift exchanges, party planning, and so on. Even though most of it looks very different this year. In Mark's Gospel today, we hear about John the Baptist. Now, John the Baptist knew all about how to prepare for something. You might even call him an expert in the area of getting things ready. That being said, John, dressed in his camel hair clothing with his diet of locust and honey, hanging out in the wilderness, probably wasn't much of an expert in areas such as decorating the Christmas tree, or putting up lights, writing out Christmas cards, or even finding the hottest Black Friday deals online. And let's be honest, probably not the type of guy that you'd picture cooking your Christmas dinner. But John had a special gift. John's specialty was in preparing the way of the Lord. Work that God had called him to do long before his birth, and work that he would carry on even until his death. John the Baptist, whose ministry was foretold today in the book of the prophet Isaiah, was chosen by God to clear the path for the coming of the Messiah and to baptize with water for the repentance of sin. John knew exactly what was on God's to-do list for his life, and he dedicated his existence to preparing the way. And by all accounts, he was quite successful in his calling. Now, John the Baptist is a character that I admire, one that I can really get on board with, not because of his status or his place in the Gospels, but because he demonstrated three qualities that I think are essential for each and every one of us as we are all called to prepare the way of the Lord. First of all, John was willing to do the work God had chosen for him. He didn't fuss about it or try to take a different, easier direction. He was willing to do the tough stuff and to do it with persistence. Secondly, John was humble. He realized his ministry was one of setting the stage, so to speak. And his humility is evident in John's gospel when we hear him say, "He must increase and I must decrease," speaking, of course, about Jesus. In some translations, he says, "There must be more of him and less of me." And thirdly, John was an unassuming character, which I guess ties into being humble. With his camel clothes, his unruly looks, and his way of life, he certainly doesn't seem like someone chosen by God to have such an important role in the narrative of the coming of a king. But God is funny like that. He often chooses those society would see as unlikely to do his greatest work. So we see the ministry of John the Baptist, and I'm sure we'd all agree that he lived out his mission of preparing the way of the Lord, checked off all the items on his to-do list. But we aren't John the Baptist, and we might even be thinking, what does preparing the way of the Lord even look like? What have I done in my life to make the path straight? And has God really even called me to do anything? The answer is a loud yes. God has called each and every one of us in our own lives to prepare the way, to live in ways that point to Jesus Christ. Let me ask you some more questions. These are a little bit different than the ones I asked a few minutes ago. How many of us have checked on family and friends over the past few weeks? How many of us have prayed for someone who is sick, ill, lonely, or simply depressed, or going through a rough time? How many of us have paid for coffee of the person behind us in the Tim's lineup? And how many of us have donated time, items, or money to a good cause? How many of us have simply smiled at a stranger this week? I know I smile all the time at the construction guys driving here every morning. They must think I'm crazy. See, when we break it all down, preparing the way of the Lord is second nature to all of us. We are all in our own ways like John the Baptist, and our ministry is no less important. We are all key players in preparing the way this Advent season. This week on Facebook, I read a bunch of stories about people doing wonderful things, and it seems to be more, I guess, prevalent this time of year. Someone, for example, decorated trees around Octagon Pond to look like Christmas trees. There was a lady who met a sweet little 10-year-old boy while shopping at Dollarama. She's gone viral now in a search for him because she wants to let his family know what an awesome little boy they're raising and make their Christmas a little brighter. Just yesterday, while myself and Reverend Byron were on a visit, we heard of a lady adopting a senior citizen for Christmas, a program which connects a senior without family around them to someone who will be responsible for taking care of their Christmas dinner and checking off their Christmas wish list. Here at Only Innocence these past few weeks, as Reverend Byron said this morning, we've been overwhelmed by the response to our Blessing Bag project. We've seen the happiness and joy that comes from helping others. Individuals, groups, Boy Scouts, Girl Guides, daycares, schools, town councils, and other churches have come on board to spread the good news in a very tangible way. So in all the busyness of preparing this Advent season, let's take time to stop and acknowledge who we are called to prepare for. And let's continue our preparation with confidence in our good work, our humility, and our unassuming characters, knowing that we are setting the stage for a beautiful story to begin once again. Let us pray. Holy, patient, and loving God, in this season of longing and anticipation, we await the coming of your Son, our Savior. It is difficult for us to remember that this is a holy time. There are many distractions, commitments seem to pile up, and expectations are high. In the midst of our busy world, our busy lives, we need your help to remind us of what is important and necessary. While many of those things that we do not need will come to us in packages gleaming and bright, the one gift that will last comes from you alone, gracious God, as we grow in our awareness of your love. Bless us, our family and friends, and the food and the company that we will no doubt share. Increase in us a growing urgency to prepare the way of your Son, in whose name we pray, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
We may now stand as we make a profession of our faith as found in the Apostles' Creed. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Continue with the prayers of the people.
As we prepare for Jesus Christ to come among us, let us offer prayers to God, saying, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace of the world and for our unity in Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all bishops, priests, and deacons, and all who minister in Christ, and for all the holy people of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Catholic Church throughout the world, and the faithful in every place, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of the nations and all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for justice, peace, and freedom among peoples of the earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For travelers, for the sick and the suffering, for the hungry and the oppressed, refugees and those in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who rest in Christ and for all the dead, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deliverance from all affliction, strife, and need, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lifting our voices with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O rising sun, brightness of light eternal, Son of justice, come and shine on those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death. Amen.
Amen. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We may stand as we pray. God, our strength, we are nothing without you. Receive all we offer you this day, as you sustain us with your mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to the Lord, our God. Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who in the fullness of time came among us to be in our flesh and opened to us the way of salvation. Now we watch for the day when he will come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, that we, without shame or fear, may rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation, in calling Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil, and make us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to you, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat, This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you do this, whenever you drink it, you do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer a sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, being acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. And bring us to that city of light, where you dwell with all your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as the Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. God of promise, you prepare a banquet for us in your kingdom. The gifts of God for the people of God. We may stand as we pray. Faithful God, we thank you for feeding us with this heavenly banquet. Help us always to hear the prophet's call to turn our hearts to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord Jesus, who loves with a wounded heart, be your love forevermore. May the Lord Jesus, who serves with wounded hands, help you serve others. May the Lord Jesus, who walks on wounded feet, walk with you to the end of the road. Look for the face of the Lord Jesus in everyone you meet, and may everyone you meet see the face of the Lord Jesus in you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. We're now able to sing, "When the King Shall Come Again."